Hello. This time we will discuss in detail about space vector PWM or SVPWM, which is an important part of field-oriented control or FOC in both BLDC and PMSM motors to produce smooth rotation, three sinusoidal current or voltage signals with a phase difference of 120 degrees are required. In the implementation of field-oriented control or FOC, the generation of these sinusoidal signals is the primary task that must be performed. There are several methods for generating sinusoidal voltage signals using PWM techniques, two of the most common being SVPWM or sinusoidal PWM and SVPWM or space vector PWM. Both utilize PWM modulation to control the average voltage magnitude across each motor phase. However, in DC systems, we cannot directly generate negative voltages. Therefore, the sinusoidal signal we create must be shifted upward so that all its values are above 0 volt, allowing it to be modulated using PWM. However, it is important to note that in a three-phase motor, what matters is not the voltage relative to ground or 0 volt, but the voltage difference between phases. If we calculate the maximum difference between the highest and lowest phases in a sinusoidal waveform only reaches approximately 0.866 times VDC, meaning we are not fully utilizing the supply voltage. This is a drawback, as the current that can be delivered to the motor is limited by the amplitude of this signal. To overcome this limitation, we increase the voltage difference between phases until it reaches the full VDC. Thus, the sinusoidal signal will increase to 1.1547 times. From here, we can see that the portion above VDC and below zero is impossible to apply with PWM. Therefore, we must shift the signal up and down like a triangle shape derived from the average between the highest phase and the lowest phase, so that the highest phase and the lowest phase do not exceed the VDC and ground limits. This results in the following space vector waveform shape, and that is why the space vector is more advantageous than the sinusoidal waveform. With the same VDC, we can achieve greater torque with SVPWM. So, how do we apply SVPWM? Let's start by understanding the basics of space vector PWM or SVPWM. On the screen, we see a hexagonal diagram representing the six basic vectors of a three-phase inverter. Each vector, from V1 to V6, shows a different combination of switch turn-on states in the inverter. At the center of the diagram is the neutral point or zero vector V0 and V7, which is generated when all switches are either on or off simultaneously. Now, let's see how these output vectors are translated into PWM signals. On the right, we can see three PWM signals representing the three phases, A, B, and C. The pulse width of each of these waves is dynamically calculated based on the position of the output vector in the hexagonal field. Now observe how the output vector rotates. We can see dynamic changes in the duty cycle of the three PWM signals. Each vector position produces a unique duty cycle combination in each phase. For example, in this position, the output vector is between V1 and V2, but closer to V1. If we arrange the switching sequence from left to right, we get the following pattern: 000, 100, 110, 111, 110, 100, and 000. If we observe, the total duration in the 100 condition is longer than in the 110 condition. By running this switching cycle at a very high frequency, the inverter will produce an average voltage that approaches the direction and magnitude of the output vector. During a full 360-degree rotation, we will see a smooth and symmetrical PWM pattern, which creates a smoothly rotating magnetic field inside the motor. I will demonstrate the application of SVPWM on an STM32 microcontroller. I use the centerline mode on the timer, so that the PWM signal is more symmetrical and produces lower switching noise. To set the PWM frequency, I have created a function to adjust the prescaler value and auto reload register, or ARR, on the timer to obtain the desired PWM frequency. In the implementation, I have created an open loop voltage control function, which includes several important steps. Starting with the inverse park transform, which is the process of converting the voltage components VD and VQ into the components V alpha and V beta in the stator frame. To speed up the calculations, I use a lookup table to obtain the values of sine theta and cosine theta. Next, the V alpha and V beta components are converted to SVPWM form through several stages, namely, normalization of the voltage vector relative to the DC bus voltage, determining the sector where the vector is located in the SVPWM hexagon, calculating the active time for the two main vectors, and finally, clamping the output value to remain within the valid range so that it can be applied as a PWM duty cycle. By setting constant values for VD and VQ and incrementally increasing the electrical angle reference, we can achieve BLDC motor rotation similar to a stepper motor with micro-stepping. The following waveforms represent the PWM values for each phase of the motor. For BLDC motors, this open loop mode is actually inefficient because a lot of energy is wasted. Additionally, the motor does not know what reference angle to provide when the load conditions change. Therefore, feedback from the rotor angle is required so that the motor can determine its actual position and calculate the direction and magnitude of the voltage vector that needs to be applied. This angle feedback can be obtained from various types of sensors, such as magnetic encoders, incremental encoders, Hall sensors, or observers, if using a sensorless mode with more advanced methods. In the next episode, we will discuss how to read the angle using a magnetic encoder. Thank you for your attention, and see you in the next episode.